Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. And in this video I will be discussing about a simple intraday strategy for stock options. It can work on index options too, however you have to be careful about the timing, which I will discuss later in this video. So before I begin, I just want to inform you that I do have a Facebook page and also a Twitter page and the Telegram channel, which you can join and follow the other social networks if you want to get live stock market updates. So yeah, so before further ado, let's begin today's session. So open hedging, what is basically open hedging? Open hedging and closed hedging are two different techniques which is used in stock markets. Now hedging itself means you're protecting your capital. That means either you are you are trading with a with a stop loss, or you have protected your capital through on the opposite side too. So that's basically hedging. Now there are so many intraday strategies available for stock options, and it becomes very difficult to see exactly where how it works. There are different bracket order techniques which is used in futures. However, in stock options, there are only few strategies which actually work most of the times. But again, I'll come to it about the stock picking and other things. So, but in futures, whenever you trade futures, there's only one problem. If you are if you have limited capital, there is a very good possibility that you would find that if you do not put a proper stop loss, then you might find it difficult to manage that loss itself, loss bearing capacity, I would say. So if you have 1 lakh capital and suddenly if you take a stop loss in futures, you would actually lose about 2,000 to 3,000, or based on your capital. I'm sorry, based on your stop loss. So what does happen is in options you have the possibility of a bounce back too. So that's the reason we use options, and there are very good possibilities where you can actually use options in your trading techniques. So here we are going to discuss one option strategy here. So now in intraday, you have to understand that when I say intraday, it's strictly intraday and you should not carry your stock options position. Now many traders make this mistake of holding the options position, just like futures or stocks, where you would always think that the stock can bounce back and you keep holding the position. But this technique should be used only on intraday, and I'll probably speak later about when you should use this technique. So you have to, there are a few steps here. Select a stock with options liquidity, and the second thing would be then find the nearest call and put, and then buy at base 5, a sell buy order. Okay, now the thing is, this should be an MIS order. So that's basically intraday order. So that means even if you do not monitor the that position, it will be squared off by the end of the day. Now I'll go this technique one by one. Now select a stock, that's the first thing you need to do. And how do you select a stock? Now selecting an intraday stock could be through various factors. If it is a result season, you have to see whether the results are going to come on the during business hours or not, during the trading hours or not. If yes, then you can select that stock, especially in high volatile stocks where you can expect a huge movement either side. So that's one thing. And there is also another website called charting, and you go to screeners and there are a lot of intraday bullish scan. Again, you can see this. For example, you can take this screener and see here and see the scan in the last 5 minutes, 15 minutes. Buy and you can select the stock. So there are different ways of picking an intraday scan. You can also pick up a stock from a crossover too. So that's the first technique. Select a stock. Now find the nearest call and put. So this works with very simple. For example, you selected a stock called Infosys. Now which is trading at around 740 rupees. For example. The nearest call, I don't know if this is 10 or 20, but I'm assuming the difference is, so the nearest call should be 760 call and 720 put. So this, usually whenever you are taking the position, picking a stock is most important. And if you, once you pick up a stock, then you can take the 15 minute candle or other things, but all you need to do is, if you generally, as I told you, there are different timings where you can put. If you are placing an order at 9:15 or 9:30, that's the my time would be at around 9:30 in the morning. And once you select a stock, then find then this would be the nearest call and put. And the third thing here is buy at day's high. So as for the last 15 minutes at 9:30, you would assume that markets have settled a bit, and either side breakout would help you in making profit. So again, you are buying at day's high, here also at day's high, and you're leaving the order till the end of the day. And the reason for that is you are making sure that you are getting the maximum profits. Even if there is a loss, there is a good possibility that will be a limited loss, because the options will not expire at zero by the end of the day. Now another important thing which you have to keep it in mind here is, you have to do with this only in the first 15 days of an expiry. You should not try this in the last 15 days of expiry, because premium decays will be faster, and then there are bigger chances of you losing money in this particular strategy in the last 15 days, even though the premiums will also be less. But I would not suggest you to try this on the last 15 days of expiry, last 2 weeks to be more precise. So the technique is very simple. Select a stock which has an options liquidity. And the reason why I say this is, many options do not have enough liquidity. Means this would be traded very well in futures, but options will not have liquidity. And by liquidity, I mean to say there should be enough buyers and sellers. What happens is with some of the options is, there will be huge spread difference. For example, a buyer is available at 1 rupee and the seller would be available at 2 rupees or 3 rupees. I would personally say that please avoid that. Even though the stock might be good, the liquidity in options might be very, very less. So that select a stock which has enough liquidity, there are enough buyers and sellers at every 5 paise or 10 paise. In that way, you can actually select that stock options very well. Again, then find the nearest call and put. Always find the nearest call and put that would be ATM at the money, which could have slightly lesser premium, and that's the reason I want you to select. And you are not directly entering into that position itself. You are actually buying at day's high, and this is an SL stop loss buy order. All right. So this would be a technique, and it's completely hedged, because if one side breaks, and after that, if it comes down and it breaks the other side, then you would have the what will happen is, for example, your 760 call has been activated, and as I told you, once after entering it, this is already executed, and for some reason this 720 PE will only be executed if there is a huge downfall, because or the side breaks. If it breaks 720, and in that case, most of the times, if both side breaks, there will be a huge one side movement. It will either break 700 and 680. So again, there would be a band, but that would break big time. And again, both sides, unless it is a range bound market, you will get profits on the other side too. So this is basically a typical method from derived from options triangle. And this would be this you can try this if you have a good capital or capital to invest in a couple of sectors. Try to invest this in three or four strong performing stocks for that day, which you can select probably from top gainers or top losers. And you can select this from preferably from different sectors. If you are selecting one from steel sector, one from IT sector, one from finance sector, three or four sectors, you can actually be in very good profit. There is a very good possibility that some orders will not be executed, and there will also be possibility that one or two might have minor losses. But if you practice this strategy for continuously for 1 month, especially in different sectors, if you see the top gainers and top losers from different sectors, and then you enter this kind of position, then there is a very good chance that you will be in overall profit by before the end of the day. So that's pretty much my view on it. This is also for this strategy is also for people who are working professionals and who do not have time to monitor the market. And that is the reason why I say that is you can leave the position till the end of the day, and there is a very good chance that you would be in huge profit if one side breaks. So so that's pretty much about it about this hedging technique on stock options. If you still have any questions related to this particular strategy, this particular options intraday strategy, feel free to ask and in on the comments below under the video, and I'll be happy to clarify your doubts for you. Thank you, and I will see you again on my next video.